Dark Cilia, ladies and gentlemen. It's time to do the showcase, baby. Dark Cilia is an absolute beast. I've been using her ever since I pulled her. Now, I do have my own thoughts about her, of course. We'll be talking about those in the video, but let's talk about what she does. So her first ability is Fatal Blow level 3. Crit damage 30% up, extremely good. She has additional attack level 3, damage 30% up during break, also another really good passive. And for the last one, she has her own unique passive, which is the Ancient Blood. Ancient Blood increases your attack by 20% every time your art is activated. It maxes out at 100%, and then once you max it, you get damage and crit rate 100% up, so she's getting 100% attack, 100% damage, and 100% crit. Sounds good to me. Her skill is 2000% dark damage physical, drains enemies' art gauge by 5, 8 second cooldown, 3000 break. Her normal art is 18,000% dark damage magic, increase all allies' art damage by 50% for 15 seconds, break 1400, and then her true art is 43,000% dark damage physical, increase all allies' art gauge by 3 for 10 seconds. If Ancient Blood is max, multiplies art gauge, autofill time, and increases its amount by 2. She is an extremely strong unit, right? She's a very strong self-sustaining DPS because she's giving herself 100% attack, 100% damage, 100% crit. 3 damage buffs, which make you hit extremely hard in this game. She's covering. She has all of that, plus she's giving your entire team art gauge, which is extremely nice. Now, let me just say this. If you're a newer player and you just got Dark Cilia, and you watch my Shuji summon, and you're like, OP, you told me to summon 4, I got her, man. I was so hyped. Good. Because she is a really good unit. Now, however, if you're starting out, it's going to be really hard for you to really get the same performance that I'm about to show you. The reason for that is because Dark Cilia is a unit that thrives off of better equips. For example, you see that we have 2 true weapons here. I'm missing 1 true weapon to have one of the most optimal setups on Dark Cilia. One of the most meta equip loadouts that you can run on Dark Cilia is literally her true weapon, Duryoric's true weapon, Deus' true weapon. However, if you're free to play, you just started playing, Relic or Deus is the 5-star physical. For the 5-star magic, get Alma's hat. It's very easy to get. Just go to the event. And then for the next 5-star magic, you know, probably do Alma's hat again. Now, if you've been playing the game for a while, but you don't have the true weapons, and you play during the Deorg event, you can use also Deorg's event equip weapon as the 5-star magics if you want to. That will also benefit her. But of course, just know that the best thing for her is going to be that Deorg 2 weapon. I know I'm spending a little bit more time on this than I usually do because I really want to break her down and tell you everything that she can do. Because this unit is extremely strong. I don't think a lot of people realize that she's a unit that gets better whenever you invest pretty much more into her. One last thing too that I would like to mention before we go on is that her true art right here, as you can see, she actually dashes into it. And because of that, you see that she's no longer on screen, right? Well, that means that she has iframes. Whenever a unit goes off screen like this, most of the time they have iframes, and she is one of these units. She is pretty much invincible during this animation, makes it very, very hard to kill. But don't think that'll just make you immortal. It just helps you out in harder content. So unfortunately, we're not going to do Ganon because oh lord. So we're going to do a Crest Palace run with Dark Cilia. We're going to be using her as a solo DPS unit. We're actually going to be running this team right here. We got Dark Cilia, Dark Finn, Rimuru, and Thetis. Rimuru's just here for the cleanse, just in case we get poisoned or something, whatever the case may be. Unfortunately, I don't have Deorg's true weapon, but he will be, that actually is the next true weapon that I am planning to buy, is Deorg's true weapon. Now, once I get Deorg's true weapon, this Dark Cilia will be an absolute monster. I'm talking about an absolute thief in the night. So you know something that's very weird though, is that her true weapon increases your own art gauge, which is really nice, but it also increases magic damage, which is weird because her true art, right, is a physical damage dealing attack, but her normal art is a magic damage dealing attack. So it's very weird that the normal art is like the thing it's buffing and not the true art, but I guess it would be a little bit too OP if it was buffing the true art as well. But yeah, man, that's just something that was weird to me because, like, whenever I first saw that, I was like, wait, she does magic damage? But no, she does magic and physical damage. So it's very weird that that's the case currently. Also, the boy Thetis is kind of low on the HP, but we should be alright. Once we start getting the art gauge flowing, which is right now, we're going to be absolutely insane. So one thing I did make sure was that Dark Cilia stacked with all these units. You have to keep that in mind with Dark Cilia. She is a B stacking unit, if I'm not mistaken. I could be wrong about that. You guys correct me in the comment section, but I think she's in Group B for the art gen groups. The ways that you can use Dark Cilia, you don't just have to spam true art, of course. You can actually alternate between her normal art, so you can give your team the art damage buff, like right here, as so, and then, you know, we pop this and we get her true art back up instantaneously, pretty much. And then, of course, this woman's trying to art me, but we got the Thetis barrier up and we're just doing damage. Now, another thing is, too, is that her normal art, don't sleep on it once you have it, right? It is another form of dealing absolute deeps, because once you have 100% attack up, 100% damage up, and 100% crit, you are just an absolute monster in everything that you do, right? I'm talking about an absolute beast in everything that you do, because as you can see right here, we're going to use the normal art, and we're just going to use normal art, and we're going to see if we can break this barrier just with the normal art. I don't think we will, because I don't think we have the accuracy buff. Oh, actually, we might. Do we have the accuracy buff? Oh, yeah, we do. My bad. We almost broke it with just the normal art. So, don't sleep on the normal art. It's really nice. Also, if you are trying to increase your damage a ton with Dark Cilia, you will be wanting to make sure that you're alternating between the normal art and true art once you have your stacks max. And as you can see right there, the boss literally stood no chance. Dark Cilia is just an absolute beast. Like, there's no other way to put it. As a pure damage dealer, she's better than, I think, pretty much anybody currently that we have in global. Especially now, too, we have her true equip, which her true equip increases all of her basic stats by 30%, so it makes her hit even harder because she has 30% more attack and stuff. And like I said, the more you invest into this unit, the more you're gonna get out of it. And she's definitely a staple unit for any type of hard content that comes in the future of this game. With that being said, there is a downside to Dark Cilia, which is just, she's a slow unit, right? It takes time for her to ramp up. It takes 500 art gauge for her to reach max stacks on Blood the Ancient. But once you reach that 500 art gauge, you start using your true art. It's very easy for you to constantly be able to fill up your old art gauge, because your art gauge is increasing by, I think it's 6 once it's at max, right? I think it's 6 art gauge for 20 seconds, which is insane. Constant true arting state, constant normal arting state, whatever you wanted to be doing at the current. But she is a slow unit. She's not going to be useful in, like, you know, very easy content, because it's just that she isn't going to be able to reach her full potential. And stuff like raids, fits, Ganon, stuff like that. Pretty much she is the go-to DPS unit, because she's just going to destroy everything. Guys, that's going to be it for the video, man. Dark Cilia in all of her glory. Is she one of my favorite units in the game? I don't know. I still feel like Dark Finn and Dark Kane still hold that spot, but she's definitely like number 2 or number 3. But thank you all for coming out. It's been your boy OP. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe for more Great Summoners content and Grand Cross content on the channel. But thank you all for coming out. It's been your boy OP. And last but not least, don't forget to drink water.